Welcome to a lesson on the ZeroProduct property. The goal of this video is to use the ZeroProduct property to solve polynomial equations in factored form. So the ZeroProduct property is one of the main reasons why we learn how to factor quadratic equations and polynomial equations. The ZeroProduct property states if two numbers a and b are multiplied together and the resulting product is zero, then at least one of the numbers must be zero. So if a times b equals zero, then either a must equal zero or b must equal zero, or both a and b are equal to zero. And we can use this idea to help us solve polynomial equations in factored form. If we want to solve the equation x times the quantity x minus 3 equals zero, because this product is equal to zero, either the first factor of x must equal zero, or the second factor of x minus 3 must equal 0. So we know one solution is x equals 0, and the second solution we have to solve this equation for x, so we'd add 3 to both sides of the equation. So minus 3 plus 3 is equal to 0, so our second solution is x equals positive 3. Again, we have two solutions, x equals 0 or x equals 3. Of course, if we wanted to, we could check this. Check x equals 0, we would substitute 0 for x. We would have 0 times the quantity 0 minus 3. Well, that would be 0 times negative 3, which equals 0. That checks. And when x is equal to 3, we'd substitute 3 for x. We would have 3 times 3 minus 3. Well, 3 minus 3 is equal to 0. So here we'd have 3 times 0, which also equals 0. And therefore checks. Let's take a look at some more examples. In this equation we have 4x times the quantity x plus 5 equals 0. Again, because this product is equal to 0, either the first factor of 4x must equal 0, or the second factor of x plus 5 must equal 0. And now we need to solve each of these equations for x to determine our solutions. So here to isolate x, we would divide both sides by 4. So this would be 1x, or just x equals 0 divided by 4 is 0. To solve this equation for x, we would subtract 5 on both sides. Plus 5 minus 5 is equal to 0, so we have x equals negative 5. Again, we have two solutions, x equals 0 or x equals negative 5. Here we have the quantity x minus 2 times the quantity x plus 7 equals 0. Again, because this product is equal to 0, either x minus 2 must equal 0 or x plus 7 must equal 0. And now we'll solve these equations for x. So here we add 2 to both sides of the equation. Minus 2 plus 2 is 0, so we're left with x equals positive 2. Or solving this equation for x, we would subtract 7 on both sides of the equation, which would give us x equals negative 7. So these are the two solutions to our polynomial equation in factored form. So hopefully now you're beginning to see why it's beneficial to have a polynomial equation in factored form. Let's take a look at two more examples. Here we have the quantity 2x plus 3 times the quantity 5x minus 1 equals 0. So either the first factor of 2x plus 3 must equal 0, or the second factor of 5x minus 1 must equal 0. And now we'll solve these equations for x. So here we would start by subtracting 3 on both sides of the equation. This would give us 2x equals negative 3. And the last step here is to divide both sides of the equation by 2. This would be 1x, or x equals negative 3 halves. Or, solving this equation for x, we would start by adding 1 to both sides of the equation. This would be 0, so we have 5x equals 1, and divide both sides by 5. So our second solution is x equals 1/5. Let's take a look at one more example. Notice in this equation we have 3 factors that have a product of 0. So in this case, we'll have 3 solutions, either x equals 0 from this first factor, or x minus 1 equals 0 from the second factor, or 6x plus 11 is equal to 0. And now we'll solve these for x. Well, the first equation is already solved for x, so we have x equals 0. The second equation will add 1 to both sides. This will give us the solution x equals positive 1. And then for the third equation, we have a two-step equation, so we'll subtract 11 on both sides, and then divide both sides by 6. So our third solution is x equals negative 11/6. So as long as we have our product equal to 0, we can take advantage of the zero product property to solve the polynomial equation. So because of the zero product property, we will spend some time learning how to factor a variety of polynomials so that we can solve polynomial equations. I hope you found this helpful.